Now we'll look at the requirements of an application. First, the patent application has to be accompanied by a provisional or a complete. And we had mentioned the difference between a provisional and a complete. If you follow the option of filing a provisional first, then within a period of 12 months, you have to follow it up with by filing a complete specification. So the provisional specification will get you the priority, but provided you follow it up by filing a complete specification within 12 months. Now, the second requirement while filing an application is the requirement of drawings. You need to have drawings if your invention can be described through drawings. For instance, most mechanical inventions involving mechanical and moving parts may require drawings. Even if you don't file the drawings, the patent controller can ask for drawings when the patent office is prosecuting your patent application. Third thing that you need to provide to the patent office while filing an application is details with regard to foreign filing. If you had filed an application in India and followed it up with applications around the world, foreign applications, then you need to keep the Indian Patent Office informed as to the position of those applications. Now, this is more like the Patent Office would like to know how other patent offices are dealing with the same application. So there is a statement of undertaking under Form 3, which an applicant has to file. The fourth thing the applicant has to file along with his application is the priority document. In some cases, there could be a priority document, which is a document filed in a foreign patent office. Now, when you follow the conventional application route or the PCT route, you file a priority document. Based on the priority document, you get a priority and then you enter different countries. So, whatever priority document that you used in the case of a convention application, copies of that has to be provided to the Indian Patent Office. Then there has to be a declaration with regard to inventorship as to who the inventor is, the name, nationality, and address of the inventor. Then a power of attorney has to be filed, or Form 26 instead of the power of attorney, authorizing the patent agent to deal on your behalf. Then the required fees has to be paid. And the proof of right, the right to make an application, has to be given. Now, this earlier, it had to be done along with filing the application. Now that provision has been removed, you've been given time to file a proof of right even after you make the application. So proof of right can now be filed even after you make the application. Now, proof of right, we had already discussed this. When an inventor assigns his invention to another person, say the employer or the company where he works, then the company, when it files in patent application, it has to show the proof of right. How did the applicant get the invention? And that has to be demonstrated with documents.